Okay, what did we discuss in the last lecture? We discussed about different types of finishing agents used for different fibers. Like for cellulosic fibers, what are the finishing agents? And for synthetic fibers like polyester, acrylic, and polypropylene, what are the types of finishing agents? And then for wool fabrics, what are the types of finishing agents? And for polyester cotton blends, what are the types of finishing agents should be used? Till that we discussed during the last lecture. So in the previous lecture, the finishing chemicals used for providing the flame retardancy on the conventional textile fibers like cotton, wool, silk, and polyester cotton blends completed. So today we will move on to further into the discussion. So first starting, you should know about one thing which is called the thermally thick or thermally thin. This is important characteristic you should know. So if you, apart from the providing the flame retardancy based on whether the fiber is flammable or not, apart from that, the material can be classified into thermally thick or thermally thin. Fire scientists normally, they tend to classify the materials which easily catch fire and which do not easily catch fire by based on the thickness. So what is meant by thermally thin? It means that when the material is exposed to flame on one surface, the heat, the flame can easily penetrate into the thickness so that there won't be any kind of a gradient. You understand what is meant by gradient? In how much degree, in how much time, that is the gradient. So there won't be any kind of a temperature gradient. Rapidly it will catch the fire and it will start burning. Okay, if you see the textile materials in general, they are all the single layered fabric assemblies. There may be, there are some fabrics which are two layer or three layers, but normally the textile materials is a single layer fabric assembly which are dimensionally thin. So they are called the thermally thin materials. But for thermally thick, if you want to make a material thermally thick, in that case, you have to use some different layers so that what will happen, the heat penetration depth will be less than the physical depth, so that if you increase the thickness of the material, there will be some gradient actually to for the heat to penetrate inside the material. So for making the material flame retardant, apart from applying the finishing chemical, the fabric which you are using should be thermally thick. Okay, otherwise what will happen? The material, if it is thin, then heat it can easily catch fire, and it can the flame can easily penetrate very rapidly without any kind of a gradient. Okay, so that you need to understand. Then next thing which we need to discuss is, which we are going to discuss, is the inherently flame retardant fibers. Okay. So previously we discussed about some four conventional fibers. They are not safe when you apply without, when you use without applying any flame retardant finish. They by itself, it is not non-flammable. It is highly inflammable. Okay, but if you want to use some textile fibers without applying any flame retardant finish, without using any finish, if directly using the fiber itself, if it is able to provide the flame retardant effect, flame retardancy, then in that case that material is called inherently flame retardant fiber. Okay, so what are they? They have the flame resistance built into their chemical structure. Okay, so if you see the polymer structure of that particular fiber, the flame resistance is incorporated into it. Okay, so these fibers do not break down into combustible molecular fragments when it is burnt. For example, if you take an inherently flame retardant fiber and just expose it to flame, it will not burn, it will not be break down, like it will not just when it is just when it undergoes the pyrolysis or combustion reaction, it will not break down into fragments as you observe for normal easily catching fire fibers like cotton or polyester. Okay, for that reason you use heat resistant organic fibers. If you see, you can use it continuously at a very high temperature. Say for example at 150 degrees centigrade, you can continuously you can expose it to temperature of say 150 degrees centigrade so that the material will not chemically or physically break down. Okay, they change a little. For example, if you expose it to high temperatures like 200 or even 300 levels, by short term exposure it may physically or chemically slightly change, but you can comfortably use it when you to the temperatures up to 150 degree continuously for a long time. Okay, so for why, what applications do we need to use this fiber, this inherently flame retardant fiber? For example, certain applications like filtration industries or mining industries where there is a high temperature exposure like gas filtration or liquid filtration, there you may need fibers with a high flame retardancy. Okay, for example, you can use an acrylic fiber, which is, acrylic is not a flame retardant fiber. Acrylic fiber can easily catch fire, but you can give a finishing coating, finishing agent to that and then use it. But in cases where the temperature is found to be much higher, then in that case it is always recommended to use the inherently flame retardant itself. So there is no need for application of the finishing chemical on the surface, so that you can directly use the inherently flame retardant fiber. So for this inherently flame retardant fiber discussion, we are going to discuss about the high performance heat and fire resistant organic polymeric fibers and then blend, which are based on carbon also, carbon based materials which contain carbon, that is why it's organic polymeric blends and fibers we are going to discuss. There are four different types of fibers which we are going to discuss, and among inside that there may be some subdivision. One is the thermoset polymeric fibers, another is the aramid or air humid fibers, then another is the polybenzazole, which is which is a family where it is
slide.
Pardon?
Slide, sir.
Huh?
Slide, sir. Slide. Huh.
Kya? What happened?
Nothing, sir.
Did not you see the slide? Was not the slide visible to you?
Yes, sir. Now visible.
Okay. There is a problem, it seems. So when it is enlarged, it is not showing the PPT. Okay, I will just present like this itself. So if you see this fibers, these are the high performance heat and fire resistant. You know, you can just recall the definitions you learned during my first lectures, flame resistant and fire resistant. Flame resistant is something that if you just recall, I will just show you the definition page which we discussed in the first, during the first lecture. Flame resistant is something different where when you expose it to flame and then just take out the flame, the material after catching the fire, it will get self-extinguished. That is called the flame resistant. But whereas for the fire resistant material, it is something very much special. You see, after you expose it to flame and remove it, both the flame propagation also will stop, also the glow also will stop. Glow is in the sense which will slow burning process, where it will show that slow burning process like a charring. Okay, so either if the material is flammable, flame, it is a little fast process, and the temperature, if you see the between the flame and glow, flame, it is a high temperature. You can just I will just show you an example. For a cotton and cellulose, the temperature of flame is around 450 and glow is around 650. So if you see this flame resistant material, after you expose it to flame and remove it, it will just self-extinguish. Okay, it will just self-extinguish by forming a slight char formation and it will stop extinguishing. But fire resistant, it is something special where it will be able to stop the flame as well as it is able to stop the glow. But whereas glow will be present in this flame resistant material. Okay, so flame resistant or flame retardant material is the one where you take a material like cotton or polyester, which is a flammable material, and apply some finish over it. And that material, if you use it, expose it to flame, you will feel that flame retardant effect. You can achieve the flame retardant effect. But for fire resistant or fire retardant material is something special. For that, you have to use inherently flame retardant fiber. Okay, so those fibers only we are going to discuss. That is the purpose of actually now recalling this discussion on the definitions. So now coming back to our discussion, so we are going to discuss a number of inherently flame resistant organic polymeric fibers and blends. One is the thermoset polymeric fiber, aramid and arimid fibers, then polybenzazole family, where polybenzimidazole and polybenzoxazole fibers, and semi-carbon fibers. So one by one we will see. So these fiber, why we are actually using this fibers, because this gives the fire retardancy. The fire retardancy and flame retardancy is something different. Flame retardancy can stop only the flame, okay, but fire retardancy will stop both the flame as well as the glow. This one you should keep in mind. So there are a number of fibers for some applications like firefighters clothing, defense and emergency textiles, high performance barrier composite, which is used in places like aerospace, surface vessels, transport, etc. So this contains a number of fibers which are organic polymeric fibers and blends, high performance. They are the meta-aramids, meta-aramidimide, para-aramids, aramid, novaloid, PBI, PBO, semi-carbon, carbon, ceramic and glass. This ceramic and glass we will discuss later. That is much special when compared to these fibers. So now, right now, we will discuss only these four fibers and their subcategories. So you can observe these fiber properties. The what is the second order temperature? That is the glass transition is how much, melting temperature, decomposition temperature, continuous usage time, and the LOI values. Okay, if you observe the compare all these fibers, you can see the LOI value is, goes higher for fibers, especially like aramid, imide, and semi-carbon, PBI, and then PBO. You can just see here. But LOI, you know very well what is meant by LOI. So even the LOI value becomes higher, the material will give the flame retardancy. But that alone is not sufficient. Apart from that, the heat intensity, whether it can sustain that much when the heat intensity is increased, that is also more important. That is what we discussed in the previous lecture, which is called the heat flux. Okay, so that we have discussed. So now we will see one by one fibers and their properties, how it gives the flame retardancy. Okay, first we will start with the thermoset polymeric fibers. So you know very well what is thermoset. Thermoset is a material which is chemically cross-linked. Okay, it will not melt, it will directly, when you expose it to high temperature, it will directly, it will degrade. Okay, so what are the best examples for this? You have already performed some practicals during the man-made fibers practicals when you did last year. One is the urea formaldehyde and another is the melamine formaldehyde, or you can say phenol formaldehyde. You can you make a thermoset polymeric fibers when you just react both these precursors. Okay, so commercially, if you see this phenol formaldehyde, the other name of phenol formaldehyde is a novaloid. Novaloid is a trade name. Okay, melamine formaldehyde, the other name, the trade name is the basophil. Just remember this. Okay, so this novaloid is otherwise is marketed in the name of kynol. Kynol, just you can remember these names. So what is the property of these fibers? Both all these melamine formaldehyde, phenol formaldehyde, or urea formaldehyde, if you see these fibers, when you react, what will happen? They polymerize, they form a cross link, it forms a rigid network, cross-linked network, which are chemically cross-linked. Okay, so these fibers, when you expose it to flame, what will happen? They just degrade into char replicas. It will just form a char and it will degrade. Okay, but if you see whether can we use this as a thermo set polymeric fibers for making some fire resistant suits, whether it is possible, what are its advantages and disadvantages, that we need to understand. So because of forming a very high cross link, these fibers these are actually weak fibers. Okay, so though the cross linked structure is formed, these fibers, you see the tenacity of these fibers is not that good. Okay, it will break when you at a very less force itself, these fibers will break. So little weak fibers. So in the case, what is the solution for this? These fibers, if you process into yarns, the yarn will break. So for making advantage of this, for taking the advantage of the heat resistance, what you need to do is you have to blend these fibers with the fibers like meta and para aramids. Okay, so that what will happen, any kind of a strength or abrasion resistance, those properties can be enhanced. And the fire retardancy also you can make use of from the thermoset by blending it with these meta and para aramid fibers, which also have a very high thermal resistance. Okay, so this is one of the way. Okay, and where these fibers can be used, it can be used in the fire blocking, heat insulation. Okay, so mainly for the heat insulating and the heat and flame protective apparel, transport seating, for example, in the aircraft seating or in the train, the upholstery seatings, for those places, these kind of fibers can be used. Okay, these fibers, by the polymer color, it has a pink color. If you see these polymers like basophil, which is the melamine formaldehyde, this has a pink color, and this kynol, it has a gold color. So you can actually convert these fibers into some non-woven felt structure by making some loose fibers you can take. So that what will happen, if you make a non-woven felt structure, this color problem, if somebody is in some places where you do not require the colors, this problem can be resolved. Next is the aramid and aramid fiber groups. This is a big family where there are a number of fibers. One is the meta aramids, next is the para aramids, and next is the technora, which is a subdivision of para aramid, and aramid, which has a subdivision of kermal. So one by one we will see. Already you have learned the aramid fibers in your previous classes. So meta aramid, you know very well what is meant by an aramid fiber. It should contain at least 85% of the amide rings bound to the benzene structure. Okay, at least 85% should be connected to the benzene structure, which contains NHCO amide groups bound to the benzene rings. Okay, so the best example for meta aramid structure is the Nomex fiber, which has a meta oriented registration. So where it can be used? It can be used in protective clothing, hot gas filtration, fire blocking fabrics, and composite reinforcement. These fibers can be used. So again, this fiber also, if you just compare the properties which you can observe from the fibers like para-aramid, these fibers, strength and other properties are not that much high when you compare it with the para-aramid fibers. Okay, that is why these fibers also, for improving the thermal performance, for example, increasing the char length, because the fiber char length, if it increases, when you just burn it, it will form a char. So that the char length, increasing the char length denotes that the material has achieved higher flame retardancy. So how to increase the performance? You just mix it with the para-aramid fibers, like for example, Kevlar or Technora. These fibers can be mixed with the meta-aramid so that this performance can be enhanced. for thermal resistance and strength properties can be enhanced. For example, nowadays these fibers, modified Normex fibers have come because this Normex is there from 1970. Okay, so if you see nowadays there are some recent developments taking place which is called the Normex 3. These fibers contain 5% Kevlar. Few amount of Kevlar you mix with the Normex and make a blend so that this can be used for a direct high heat exposure. These fibers can be used. The recent one in 2013, which is called the Normex MHP fiber. This is also a blend of the meta-aramid and the para-aramid. So these fibers, what is that? What is the advantage of blending these fibers? Because of blending, what will happen? It will produce inherent multi-hazard protection. Okay, whenever this fire accident takes place, it is not only the heat and flame. In some cases, there is a property called arc flash. Okay, this is called something called the flashover, where there is a sudden electrical explosion. Okay, because of some circuit ground earthing problems in a place where there is a sudden electrical explosion, where that will cause a rapid fire with a high heat flux. In that case, what will happen? It will lead to a very higher accident. Okay, so in that case, a very high thermal resistance is required. Whether the material is able to sustain that much of a heat flux. Okay, and another important thing which you need to remember is this molten splash. Okay, this is the, for example, during a flashover or an arc flash, because of the electrical explosion, if the materials are just something like a bursting, like a very high heat explosion, that time what will happen? The metals will melt and it will just splash onto the body. So what will happen if the metal, molten metal, falls on the body? It will create a severe accident. Okay, it lead to death also. So in that cases, for example, industries like metal manufacturing industries or metallurgy. So these places, definitely there are protective garments required that demand very high heat protection. That is called the multi-hazard protection. Okay, many type of dangers it should be able to protect. Okay. So this is one of the way. The next is the para-aramids. You know very well para-aramid. Para-aramid, it is the aramid fibers where the molecular arrangement is in the terms of the para-orientation. Benzene rings are placed, this NHCO, amide group, and the benzene rings are connected in the para-oriented fashion. The best example for this fiber is the Kevlar. Okay. There are some other variants also called Twaron. This is marketed by the company called Teijin. Twaron is also a commercial name. Kevlar is also a commercial name, but the chemical name is the polyparaphenylene terephthalamide, which is otherwise called PPTA abbreviation. Okay. These fibers, they have a low hydrogen to carbon ratio. This importance of hydrogen to carbon ratio we have already discussed. If the hydrogen to carbon ratio becomes higher, then the material can easily catch fire. If it reduces, then it is better for the achieving the flame retardancy. Okay, these fibers have a low H by C ratio. For example, it will be less than one for fibers like para-aramids. Okay, and their LOI values also higher, like 29 to 31. Okay, so this is the para-aramid fiber. But there are some disadvantages with these para-aramid fibers also. Though it gives good flame retardancy, the problem with this is processing the fibers is difficult because it's a heavy fiber. Okay, it is not like a meta-aramid fiber where the processing is easy. Here, these fibers, because of the arrangement of the para-oriented structure, it forms a very high symmetrical structure. Okay, something like this. You can just see highly symmetrical structure. So this highly symmetrical structure leads to higher orientation. The molecular polymer chains have a very high orientation because the intermolecular forces of attraction, this gets increased. So because of that, material becomes heavy. So heavier materials has a processing related problems and it has a high modulus. So because of that, processing problems are there. And apart from that, it is high cost. So this material has a main advantage of the achieving the higher flame retardancy. That is the great advantage. And these materials, other advantages, you can say, these materials absorb moisture also. 6% moisture it can absorb. So that is also another advantage for applications like apparel, where some moisture absorbency is also desired. So that is an advantage. Okay, higher modulus stiffness. So this is the high strength, high modulus fiber. Okay. So for example, if you, for a technical application, you want to use like a fire blocking material, like a fire resistant curtain, if you want to make, where the curtain is the something which will easily catch fire. When you apply flame at the bottom, easily it can propagate the fire. For fire resistant curtain, if you want to use, you may use this aramid fiber. But again, the wherever application, the performance demands are more important. For a technical application, this is fine. But for apparel, for any kind of an apparel, comfort is also very important. So in that case, what you have to do, you have to mix it with some fibers. As you have, we have discussed for the meta-aramids, you have to mix it, the meta-aramid fiber with the para-aramid fiber. So that what will happen, some textile properties also you get. You get the flexibility, the stiffness is reduced, so that it is preferable for apparel-oriented fibers to mix with the meta-aramids. Okay. So another variation of this fiber is the Technora fiber. Okay. So this is also comes under the family of para-aramids. You can see the benzene rings are placed in the this amide and groups are in the placed in the para-oriented fashion. So this company called Teijin, they 1985 they marketed this fibers, this para-aramid fibers. The difference in this fiber, between this fiber and Kevlar fiber, is a small difference. Okay, in Kevlar, the you used to poly paraphenylene terephthalamide. Okay, but whereas here you used co poly paraphenylene terephthalamide. Yeah, just a copolymer of this fiber. Okay, co poly paraphenylene 3,4- oxydiphenylene terephthalamide. Name is little complex, but just know that it is just a copolymeric structure of the previous fiber. Okay. So if you see, this fiber has some advantages associated with this. What are the advantages? This fiber has a higher chemical resistance than PPTA. Okay, and apart from that, this has a higher abrasion and steam resistance for a protective application. Wherever the exposure of steam or abrasion or chemical exposure is there, there this fiber gives the higher protection. Okay. So apart from the regular thermal resistance, it also provides additional properties. For example, if you see thermal resistance, this fiber has a higher decomposition temperature, around say 500 degrees centigrade. And if you see the LOI value is slightly less, but other properties are good. For example, for certain applications, you may require, apart from the thermal resistance, you may require additional properties. Like for example, chemical protective suits, if you want to develop a chemical protective suit. In that case, you may require higher chemical resistance along with the flame resistance. Okay, so that one property can be slightly compromised and another property can be improved further so that you can use this. So the problem is this fiber has a slightly lower LOI when you compare it with the para-aramid fibers. Another fiber family in this para-aramid family is the air emits. Okay, from this word here, you can see the word called emits. Normally, it is amide, means you know very well NH and CO, that is the amide. Okay, but what is this imide? Imide is something which is coming from the imide structure. Okay, so this fiber air imide is the based on the polyimide based structure. Okay. So what is the trade name for this fiber, like Kevlar or Technora? This fiber has a trade name called P84. Okay, so it is a commercially successful fiber. It actually has a history where it was initially introduced by a company called Lenzing during the mid-1980s and then sold to Inspect Fibers. And 2007, this fibers is under the company of, say, Evonik Fibers GmbH, Germany. So here, if you see, this contains the imide structure. Okay, this is something like where like you know what is the difference between the amide and the imide structure. So here, if you see, this structure contains imide groups where carboxyl, two carboxyl groups are connected with the nitrogen groups. Here you can see C, this C double bond O, and here C double bond O, this is connected with the nitrogen, something like anhydride type of a structure. Okay, so here this C double bond O and this C double bond O, these are the azyl groups where the carboxylic, in the carboxylic acid, if the OH is removed, only C double bond O is remaining. So two azyl groups are connected with the nitrogen. Okay, so like this, this structure continues. So this is the imide structure. Okay, benzene ring is connected with the imide structure. So this is fiber commercial name is the air imides. Okay, so what is the properties of this fiber? These fibers, if you see, they are slightly weaker than meta-aramid fibers. It is not heavy, so it can be easily processable. Okay, so where it is used, you can use it in the protective outerwear, underwear, and gloves, or you can use sometimes it for application where their strength is not that much important. You can use this fiber directly 100%, or you can blend it with the low cost fibers like flame retardant viscose or meta-aramid, so that strength also will get improved. So that is the advantage of using these fibers. Next is the Kermal fiber. Kermal, this is also again the para-aramid family. Under this family only this Kermal fiber is coming. So this fiber, if you see, this fiber is based on polyaramid aramid fiber. Okay, that is why it is called the Kermal fiber. This company called Rohn Paulenc, during 1971 they produced this structure fiber, and now it is in this company from France called Kermal. They independently produce this fiber from 2007 onwards. This fiber also, you see, it is similar to aramid. If you just see the structure, you can see here the aramid fiber, this imide group is there. Here also you see the same imide group is there with the benzene ring. Only some subtle, some very slight variations will be there in the structure if you just notice. Mostly the structure will remain the same. So this is also an imide type of a fiber. Okay, there will be some slight change in the process manufacturing condition, but overall you see all these fibers, whether it is a Kermal or Technora or the normal PPTA or the meta-aramid fibers like Nomex, all have the higher aromaticity. Okay, only the different main difference that exists in the Nomex is the meta-oriented registration, but whereas in these fibers like Technora, Kermal and aramids, it has a para-oriented registration. Okay, so what is the advantage of this making this para-oriented registration that I have told you? This gives a very high intermolecular force of attraction, so that intermolecular registration of these benzene will lead to better strength and higher modulus, and the symmetrical structure and orientation give the advantage. And in these fibers, when just observe this polyaramid imide, or whether it is the air imide fiber, both have the same chemical structure. So what is the use of this making this imide structure? So these structures, if you make, there are some advantages, like it is slightly weaker. So what will happen? The processing problems can be improved. Okay, so for certain applications where you do not require a very high strength and want easily processable, you want to easily dye this or make into textile fabrics type of a structure, so this is an advantage. So this is about the Kermal fibers. What are the properties? Properties, it is similar to meta-aramids with better dyeing properties. Normally you see for these high performance fibers, the dyeing properties are not that good. It is difficult to dye certain fibers. For example, even the thermoset fibers, if you see, the dyeing the thermoset fibers is difficult. Okay, so in order to make it processable, we make certain modification in the polymerization. So here, this kermal fiber, they are similar to that of metaaramids with the better dyeing properties. But one thing to note here is all these paraaramid fibers, whether it is a metaaramid or a paraaramid, they have a poor UV stability. Okay, their UV resistance is not good. If you expose it to higher radiation sources, it will the color will change. Okay, so this also has a good application where it can, you can use it as 100% or blend it with the fiber like flame retardant viscose or wool, or you can make some composite yarns like you can like a, for example, if you want to make a bicomponent fiber, okay, like a composite yarn where the core will have a different fiber and sheath will have a different fiber. For example, a yarn with the paraaramid core, say 35%, and a kermal fiber wrapping, so that what will happen, that will give good abrasion resistance. The core will be the paraaramid that will give the strength, and the kermal fiber will have the wrapping so that it will have little flexibility and abrasion resistance and good dyeing properties. These things you achieve from this doing some modification, okay, like producing a bicomponent fiber. So this is advantage. Next is the polybenzazole fiber group. Okay, so this one, all these fibers, when by whichever we are discussing after the thermoset, these are all based on the application of high amount of aromatic structures. Okay, so these fibers are called the ladder polymers. They are wholly aromatic. The aromaticity is very high. Okay, so this fibers structure we are going to see now. So here there are two in this polybenzazole fiber group family. There are two fibers that are important. One is the polybenzimidazole. It is otherwise abbreviation is the PBI. Okay, it is marketed by the company called Intertech, which is previously called Celanese. This full chemical name is poly-2,2-metaphenylene-5,5-bibenzimidazole. And another fiber in the same polybenzazole family is the PBO, which is the polyparaphenylene-benzobisoxazole. Okay, just to remember this word, benzobisoxazole and benzimidazole. Okay, this is important. Okay, benzobisoxazole and benzimidazole. If it is benzimidazole, it is PBI. If it is benzobisoxazole, it is PBO. So what is this PBI and PBO that we will see now? So this PBI fiber has a history where it is introduced into markets long back, before 30 years, and recently during 2005, this Celanese company sold this fiber to Intertech, and these products have started to come from the Intertech. They have this polymeric structure like this. Okay, so the structure, if you see, there is a benzene ring which is connected with NH and N groups. Okay, so what is this benzene? This one you know very well, this is a benzene structure. And what is this group? Okay, this group is the imidazole. Just to remember this word called imidazole. Okay, this group is called the imidazole. Okay, so if you just write, you can, I'm for the name, I'm writing here, this is the benzene structure. Okay, and this structure is called the imidazole. Okay, what is this imidazole structure look like? Where a benzene ring contains two non-adjacent nitrogen atoms. This adjacent, this two nitrogen, they are not close to each other. This is actually separated by a carbon. Okay, so this NHCN, this is the difference. This is called the imidazole. So that is why this fiber is called benzimidazole, where the benzene and imidazole, they are connected. Okay, so what is use of connecting this? There are advantages that you obtain in the property. Okay,
So these fibers, they have much several times superior when you performance, higher thermal performance you get by connecting these two structures. They are used in place, they are very superior fibers where it is used in firefighters' clothing in US and UK, in the outer shells, underwear, hoods, socks and gloves, industrial workwear, aluminized proximity clothing, military protective clothing and fire barrier blocker application. So these places where the high, very high thermal resistance is required, that those applications demand the use of this PBI fibers. Okay, that is why we, the reason for connecting this benzene ring and the imidazole is to obtain a very high flame retardant. Whatever the properties of imidazoles are there, imidazole has that property will be obtained. Okay, so that is the reason why this benzene ring is, it has a fused structure of the benzene ring with the imidazole structure. Okay, next is the PBO fibers. This is marketed by a Japanese company called Toyobo. This commercial name is the Xylon. You can just note this. It is a recently developed fiber of the polybenzazole fiber group. They have a rigid structure. So what is the difference in the structure? Same benzene ring is connected with another group. Which is the group? The group is the bisoxazole group. Okay, benzo bisoxazole. This is the oxazole group. Here you can just see the structure. This is the oxazole group. Okay, this oxazole group, if you observe where the nitrogen, N nitrogen, carbon and oxygen, okay, there is a single nitrogen which is connected with the carbon and then oxygen. This is the oxazole group. So because of connecting this benzene and the oxazole, it provides a rigid structure. Okay, so what will happen if you expose it to flame? These fibers do not produce any fuel forming aliphatic carbon hydrogen. Okay, so if you, this carbon hydrogen, you know very well it is hydrocarbon, where it will easily, it will start burning. So because of making the fiber, the polymeric chains become more rigid, so that you obtain, you prevent the fuel forming aliphatic carbon hydrogen group. So this fiber has a very high thermal resistance. So if you see the properties, these fiber properties have excellent tensile properties as well as thermal and fire properties. They have two different classes like Xylon AS and Xylon HM. There are some variation in the modulus. This fiber Xylon HM has the higher modulus and burning behavior. If you observe, both have the same very high thermal resistance. It is available in the form of a continuous filament, staples, sponions, and you can use this in the wide range of fire protective applications. And where it is used? It is used in the very high-end application, like wherever the cost is not that important, okay, but where the performance is more, and performance and quality is important. So those places, this PBO fibers find application, like aircraft fragments, heat barriers or protective clothing, where the strength is required, a modulus is required, fire resistance required is very high. Those places, these PBO fibers can be used. Okay. Next is the our discussion on the last fiber from this heat resistant organic fibers called the semi-carbon fibers. So from the word semi-carbon, you can understand it is partially carbon. Hope you know very well how the carbon fibers are manufactured. You have already learned during your man-made fibers course, like you do some three steps: oxidative stabilization, carbonization and graphitization, where at every step there may be some elimination of some fragments, and finally there will be a highly graphite structure, which is a fused, highly packed carbon fiber you will get. For that you will use a very high temperature in every step. Okay, So the same process is going to be used to manufacture this fiber, where this fiber will contain essentially the carbon. Okay, so if you see what is the raw material for this fiber, the raw material used for the carbon fiber is the semi-carbon fiber, is also the same raw material that you use for the making the normal carbon fiber. It is acrylic or polyacrylonitrile, where you use a controlled high temperature oxidation during the first stage of carbon fiber production, and then you produce the semi-carbon fiber. Okay. So these fibers, if you see, when you compare it with the only carbon fibers, these fibers have the acceptable textile properties. That is very important. These fibers have an acceptable textile, but carbon fibers, if you see, that does not have the acceptable textile property. But these fibers have the acceptable textile property due to the because it is partially carbon, it is not completely carbon, that you need to understand. Okay, so because the process that you are using to manufacture, it is a controlled high temperature oxidation of acrylic fibers, okay, during the first stage of the carbon fiber production. So there is a modification in the process you do, and then you make the fiber. So these fibers, you see, some examples are commercial names are Panox, Pyromax, Pyron. These are the trade names under which these fibers are sold. They have the very high LOIR of around, say, 55% volume percent. Okay, they are extremely heat resistant and give some negligible smoke and toxic gases when it is subjected to most intense of the flames. Okay, so because of the higher LOI, because of the highly covalently bond structure, okay, highly packed structure, this fiber, normally the carbon fibers do not melt easily. You have to use a very high temperature of, say, 2000, 3000 or 5000 degrees temperature. You have to use that temperature, it may melt and vaporize. But otherwise, the fibers have a both the thermal resistant as well as the textile property. If you see, these fibers, advantage when you compare it with the normal carbon fiber is normal carbon fiber, it is used in the color is in black in color. Okay, so for these fibers, if you just compare, these fibers are also black, so that it can be used in applications where like barrier fabric and military and police coverall clothing, where the black color can be used, still used in the for a uniform type of clothings can be used. And another advantage is it has a lower cost when compared with the fibers like PBI and PBO, which are actually much costly fibers. So these fibers, where you can use, there are multiple applications like anti-riot suits, tank suits, flame retardant underwear, fire blockers for aircraft seat, and heat resistant felt, insulation felts, hoods, gloves. It can be used, and you can actually metallize this fiber so that any kind of a fire entry or fire proximity suits you can make, so that the thermal radiation prevention is possible by when you just to do the metallic coatings. If you can do on these fibers, that is possible. So because these fibers have the textile property, that is the advantage of these fibers with the higher thermal resistance. Okay, so you see, today we have discussed a number of fibers in this heat and fire resistant family, fire resistant organic fiber family. There are a number of fibers and blends we have seen, like in thermoset we have seen basophil and kynol. And in the aramid, we have seen a number of fibers like a normal Kevlar fiber, which is based on PPTA. Then we have seen the Technora, then Kermal fibers, then polyaramid, aramid fibers. Next, we discussed about polybenzazole, where we discussed on two different fibers. One is the PBI, and another is the PBO. Okay. And then what did we discuss? Finally, we discussed about semi-carbon fibers. Okay, so what you are supposed to know from this learning this inherently flame retardant fiber, you should know the very basic how it is manufactured and what structure chemically it contains,
what are its properties with little applications. Okay, so that you are supposed to know, because our intention is not to learn this fiber manufacturing in so detail, but we are just to know some basic level how this fiber is manufactured and its application, chemical structure, and how it provides the thermal resistance. Okay, so that's all about the high performance heat and fire resistant organic polymeric fibers and blends, which are inherently flame retardant fibers to impart the fire resistance. Okay, in our next lecture we will move on to discuss about inorganic fibers. Okay, that's all for today. If you have any doubt, you can ask, otherwise we can stop here for today.